If you're looking for applications that respect your privacy, offer tons of features, and are completely free, this video is going to be really helpful because I'm going to share 5 amazing open source Android applications that are not just fast and powerful, but they also come with zero advertisements, with very minimal or no trackers. Sounds exciting, right? Let's go! You might have seen that open source Android keyboards are not very competitive at the moment. There are some really good ones like Floorsboard or Openboard, but they have their own problems and you might end up leaving them. But today, I am going to show you an excellent open source keyboard application that could change your overall perspective. It's called Futo, an open source Android keyboard that offers a better privacy because it does not need any internet connection, so it's completely offline. One big issue with open source Android keyboards is word suggestions. Floorsboard is getting better with updates, but it is not perfect at the moment. Futo keyboard, on the other hand, and has done a great job. I tried the word suggestions after loading a dictionary and it's working fine. If you want to add your own dictionary that is not present on the keyboard, you can download it from GitHub and load it into Futo keyboard. It is very easy. I will also provide links to all the resources that are required for Futo keyboard in the video description, so you can go ahead and check them out. Now, Futo keyboard also allows a lot of customization. Just look at how many features it provides. You can choose different languages and models or adjust other things like the keyboard size, vibration, or enable swipe typing, which is currently in alpha stage. If you are worried about themes, well, Futo keyboard has got you covered there as well. It offers around 14 themes, ranging from dynamic to AMOLED. Do I like this keyboard? Yes, I do. I'm still exploring it to make it better for me, but you should definitely give it a try. Okay, the second application now. Do you like the default clock application that comes with your phone? I do like the Mi clock on my Xiaomi phone, but if there's a better open source alternative, I am going to try it for sure. The application is called Chronos. Name is cool. Application is the coolest. There is nothing flashy about this application. It's a simple clock that lets you set the alarm and comes with a timer and a stopwatch. One standout feature is the animations that are really smooth, and it also offers some other important features like the sleep reminder, which is really easy to set up. Another excellent feature that you get with Chronos is the custom backgrounds and ringtones that really level up the overall functionality. This application does not require any unnecessary permissions, so you don't need to worry about privacy issues here. Now let's take a look at our next application called Binary Eye. This is a really handy open source application that is going to let you scan or create any type of QR code. The home screen is clean and simple, which is great. You'll see the scanner right in the middle. You will also find a zoom slider and a flash option at the bottom. To save your scan history, just go to the settings and enable the option for it. If you are at an event or managing inventory, tap the 3 dots on the top right and turn on continuous scanning. This way, every scan gets saved automatically. Creating a QR code is just as simple. Tap on the plus icon, type in your content. It can be the text or a URL. Then choose from various formats. You can even improve the accuracy by increasing the error correction level. Plus, you have the options to pick the color like black on white, white on black, or even a transparent background. You can also set the size and margin as per your requirement. And there you go, your QR code is ready. Save it, share it, or add it to your scan history. The next open source application is Disky, an incredibly useful application for managing your Android device storage. It is beautifully designed and super handy for keeping track of what is taking up space on your Android device. As you open the Disky application, you'll immediately notice the clean and modern interface. At the top, it shows the free and used space on your device, which is super helpful for getting a quick overview of your storage situation. Below this, Disky categorizes everything for you, showing exactly how much space each category is taking up. You can sort the items alphabetically or by size, making it super easy to find large files or specific items you are looking for. You can tap on any category to see the detailed information. In the applications category, you can check the usage of individual applications, including their cache, user data, and application size. Similarly, in other folders, you can check the individual files. If there is something you no longer need, you can delete it right from here. So there you have it, Disky. A stylish and a practical storage manager for Android, and you can find the download link in the description below. Now, the last and final application for today's video is Play Deals. If you are looking for the best offers on Google Play Store applications, then Play Deals is just for you. It will help you find the top deals on Play Store applications very easily. Right on the homepage, you will see many applications with amazing offers. Whether you are looking for applications with big discounts or the ones that have gone free, Play Deals has it all. The best part is the wide range of categories you can explore, from tools and productivity to finance and puzzles. There's something for everyone. Now, you might notice that the prices are shown in US dollars by default, but don't worry, just tap the hamburger menu, go to settings, and switch the display currency to Indian rupees. Now, all the deals will be in rupees. Whether you are into gaming, productivity, or just looking for applications to make life easier, Play Deals has something for you. Plus, the application is always updated with the latest deals. And that was the video, guys. Let me know in the comments which application was your favorite. And if you are interested in more open source applications, I have got plenty of content on my channel that I am sure you will find helpful. So don't forget to check it out. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you in the next one.